guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial on this look that you see right here. I don't know what I'm naming this video, but this is definitely like my version of Christmas glam. Like, I just wanted to do something so holiday and Christmassy and festive. I do not decorate my home with like reds and greens, like that typical beautiful holiday look. Everything in my house is like golds and silvers and whites, like very white Christmassy. So I wanted to bring to life that festive, classic, traditional holiday glam, but with my own extra as f twist. In today's video, I also tried out the new Kylie Cosmetics concealers and her brushes. Bum, bum, bum! So I'm gonna stop babbling. I hope you guys enjoy this makeup tutorial, kind of like a get ready with me. Get with me, makeup tutorial. I don't even know the difference anymore at this point, honestly, but I love you guys. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy. Hey guys, I wanna talk to you like this right now. Yeah, this blemish right here, I have to say blemish because it just makes me so much girlier. It's a blemish. It's actually playing me so hard right now, and it looks like a wart. Just so emotional about Christmas. It's just such a holly jolly time. That's crooked. Straighten out, bitch. Straighten. My God, stop embarrassing me. Let's jump into it because I am not in the mood to deal with this right now. So let's just go ahead and cover that little bitch up. I'm gonna prime my face right now. Oh my God, and I'm using a brand new bottle of this primer. There's something about the first pump of a primer that you're just like, ah! These hoops have got to go for a minute because those are gonna get annoying real quick. So let's just get in there and start beating thy face, shall we? Recently, I have been using the Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation, and I just like do stripes on my face. This has been my current foundation routine. And honey, you know mama likes that full coverage look. So let me just... I'm gonna grab my Dior Forever, the best foundation in the entire world. I'm gonna do a couple pumps of that in the back of my hand. I'm gonna take off these bracelets. These bracelets are a little too jolly for me. I have been using a beauty blender. Well, not technically a beauty blender. I always call it beauty blender, just like I always call tissues Kleenex. Like, I never say, can you hand me a tissue? I always say, can you hand me a Kleenex? Even though Kleenex is a brand, beauty blender is a brand. I have been using this beauty sponge so much recently. It is like the only way that I've been applying my foundation. I don't know, I'm just like in it. I'm in this beauty blender phase right now. I use my beauty blender for everything. Like, I've been using it to highlight with, I've been using it for my concealer, my foundation, everything. Like, I just love it. I'm gonna grab the Tatcha Luminous Dewy Skin Mist because this is the way that I have been applying my foundation recently. I like soak my, I soak my sponge and then I just like pat everything in. Because I feel like it just, not I feel like, it does. It makes my foundation look so much more natural and less cakey. But that is also because I am dry, definitely. So if you're oily, that might not be the case for you. But I just love the way it makes my foundation look overall. Like, the end result is just so much more flawless and natural looking. I'm going to be testing out the new Kylie Cosmetics concealers today. I am very intrigued by them. I'm going to be going in with the shade Stone. She did send me every single shade in her PR kit. Her shade range really does look awesome, so I will give her a thumbs up for that. The consistency is definitely different than any concealer that I have tried in a long time. Like, she definitely didn't like steal a formula from anybody, you know what I'm saying? Like, this honestly seems like she wasn't inspired by anyone at all. This is very unique. It almost feels like paste when it goes on. It does feel a little dry and pasty, so I'm gonna take my beauty sponge and I'm gonna put a little bit of the Tatcha Luminous Dewy Skin Mist. Oh my God, I look crazy right now. It's definitely a full coverage concealer for sure, which I appreciate. Like, I love a full coverage concealer. I don't even see the point in a concealer that isn't full coverage. I'm like, give it to me dirty, give it to me nasty, just cover up that under eye. Like, that's what I'm looking for. My AC unit in my new house has not been working recently, so I have had 5 men here since 8 a.m. working on it, and they're still here right now, like installing a whole new unit. It sucks because like this is a brand new house and the AC unit just stopped working. So I'm like, the builders decided to put in a really cheap unit that was not fit or qualified for this house at all. So they're still here right now, and I'm just like down here filming, and they're like up in my attic, and I'm just like, like right now I can hear them with like a vacuum cleaner. I'm like, are they cleaning my house? Is that gonna be an extra charge? No, really, I hear my vacuum cleaner. Hold on. Okay, that man was literally vacuuming my floors. Yes, bitch. Okay, so for today, I'm going to be using the Laura Mercier Candle Glow Sheer Perfecting Powder in the shade 1. This is the, whoopsies, this is the lightest shade, which I wish it was a little bit lighter, honestly. And I'm not even the palest girl in the entire world. But I'm gonna be using this because I just wanna try it out. I've used it like one time in the past, but I never used it with my beauty sponge, which is the way I've been applying powder recently. Ooh, yes. That's so nice, because it's like really sheer. It's not full coverage at all, which I like my powder to be really sheer, because I like a full mask of foundation with a sheer powder over top. I'm gonna grab the Kat Von D Shade and Light Contour Palette. I'm gonna go with the first shade right here, which is obviously my favorite shade in the palette. I'm gonna use this side of the beauty sponge. I'm just gonna tap it in there a little bit, and I'm going to use that to set my under eye area. So now that I have on my full mask, it literally looks like this is like a butt chin. Like, what is that? Okay, I'm gonna go in and do my brows real quick, and everyone does their brows differently, so I'm gonna just cut this out of the video and I shall be right back looking very crazy. I'm back, and like I promised, looking scary. I wiped the foundation off of my lips, but they are feeling a little chapped, so I'm just gonna throw them some gloss really quick. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do on my eyes is go in with a bright red cream shadow base to really make everything pop. This is by Makeup Geek right here in the shade Poison. I don't even know if these are still sold by Makeup Geek or if they were discontinued, but you can use anything red and creamy. I think NYX has some, then they're very inexpensive. You can honestly even use a red lipstick or a liquid lip and just make sure that you blend it out pretty quickly. I'm just gonna pick this up and just begin to pat it all over my entire lid. As I'm doing this, I'm not gonna keep my eye like kind of saggy like this. I'm gonna like pull up my eyebrow really high and really intense so I have no wrinkles in my lids and I can really see every single thing that I'm doing. That way that cream doesn't settle in any of those lines and I can really see exactly where I'm placing it. So right now you can see it's all over the lid, but I'm gonna bring it up. Whoa, I almost hit myself in the face. I'm gonna bring this up on the outer crease a little bit higher because I am going to extend this color up in this area. So I'm just gonna kind of drag it around here, stamping, going back and forth in like these weird kind of padding, dragging motions. I'm gonna grab another pencil brush and just go over those edges because I really want this to be as blended out as possible because it'll just make everything so much easier the more blended this is once we start getting into the powder shadows later. Okay, so now I'm gonna grab some translucent powder. I am just going to put this right underneath my eye because we're gonna be going in with a lot of dark, intense, vibrant colors, and I don't want it to ruin the base that I have put all over my face. The rhyme was so good. Okay, so for today's look, I'm going to be using the Kylie Cosmetics brush set that she sent right here. The ever so famous, ever so popular, ever so hated and talked about brushes right here for $360. You can see I used the first one right there on my bronzer. I'm gonna be using these so I can kind of give you guys a review, first impressions of these as I am doing my makeup. I'm gonna start off by going with the shade Creamsicle right here. And I'm gonna be using the Kylie Jenner brush in number 12. And I'm just going to place this right along the upper area where we blended that cream shadow out just to give it that warmth and make sure that it is looking fire. This brush is much stiffer than what I'm used to, but don't hate it. I feel like I might have to go in with something a little bit looser and fluffier here in a minute, but let's see. Let's feel it out. Let's see. So now I'm gonna pick up the shade Jax right here, which is a matte burgundy red. And I actually don't have a brush from the Kylie collection that I want to use because I'm really looking for something like the Morphe M433 that looks like this right here. Sorry, you're out of focus. It looks like that. The closest one that she has, because the one that I just used, I don't want to dirty. That one's flat on the top. This one is 13. I'm just going to try it. I'm just going to try it and we'll find out. I'm scared because this isn't going to blend. This brush is not going to have blending power. Oh, bitch. Okay. I'm not trying to be hype maintenance biatch, but that brush is just not doing what I need it to do. I'm not saying it's a bad brush. It's just, I don't see anything in her brush kit that is going to give me what I need, you know, like as far as this moment. So I'm gonna go in with a different brush. I'm gonna grab a Morphe brush. This is the R39 by Morphe right here. I used this earlier with like the same red color. So I'm going to just do that instead because I can see where this is going and it's not gonna be a good place. So we're just gonna go ahead and do this because I know it's gonna work. Okay, so I'm gonna go back in now with that number 13 brush from Kylie, and I'm gonna pick up a little bit of the shade Hunts right here in my palette, and I'm just gonna go right over that edge. I will say her brushes pick up a shit ton of pigment. Much more than a typical natural hair would, but they are also very compacted with bristles, like they're very stiff, which is gonna pick up like a lot. I'm gonna continuously go back and make sure this is completely blended out, barely touching it, just super, super light, so we don't have any harsh, blunt lines there on the edge. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back in with the Kylie concealer in the shade Stone, and I'm gonna pick up her brush in number 14. I'm going to carve out a little area in the inner corner of my eye where I can go in with some shadow and glitter. So I'm gonna put them in the back of my hand. I'm gonna just scoop that up, and then I'm just gonna go in and pat this area. This brush is definitely bigger than what I would typically use for this, but we're just gonna see what happens right now. Lord be with us. Okay, I'm gonna go in with the Morphe M421, and it's just a smaller, stiffer brush, because I just feel like this is gonna like pack the punch that I need, and it's just better for what I'm doing. I'm gonna go in with the shade Queen right here, which is this true gold shade from my palette. I'm gonna be picking up just a MAC 242 for this, because there's nothing in the Kylie kit that I can use for this as of right now, and the only brush that I possibly could use for it is already dirty because I just got done using it. So I'm gonna pick this up, I'm gonna spray a little bit of Fix Plus on it, and I'm just going to tap it right on here. I'm just going to lightly tap this over on top of that dark matte burgundy shade that I put over here. My brush is no longer wet with Fix Plus. It is just a tiny bit of that gold eyeshadow just to kind of mesh it all together. Then I'm gonna grab some Makeup Geek. It's a Makeup Geek kind of day. My second Makeup Geek product in this video. I'm gonna use the pigment in the shade Liquid Gold, and it is like really, really intense. Like, whoa, intense. But I just feel like this is gonna work, like, cause it's got like that really intense green undertone. It's gonna work for the holidays. Just picking that up on the exact same brush. I'm gonna just dab this right in the inner corner. Oh yes, I'm into this. I am into this. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with some loose glitter, because I feel like I can't do a holiday look without glitter personally. So this is the Makeup Forever number 11 loose glitter. So in order to make this glitter stick, you have to use a glitter glue. You cannot just take a glitter and put it on your eye. It might look cute for 5 seconds, but it's gonna fall, it's gonna ruin your lash, it's gonna ruin your makeup. So my favorite glitter glue ever is the Lit Cosmetics glitter glue. It is a little bit of a pain because it's online only, but still it is so worth it, and a bottle will last you forever. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna dip my brush right into that Lit Cosmetics glitter glue, get it a little damp, and then I'm just going to tap wherever I'm going to want that glitter to stick. Then I'm just gonna dip my brush right into that glitter, and I have a ton on my brush right there. I'm gonna tap off on my hand a little bit of the excess, so it's just like that. And then I'm just going to place it really lightly over top of it. Oh my God, I'm obsessed. Are you kidding? Okay, I'm gonna grab a brush. I'm gonna dust away this under eye area so that we can work on the lower lash line. I'm gonna pick up the shade Enchanted right here in the bottom center of my palette, which is like this matte kind of foresty hunter green. I'm gonna use a Morphe brush again. This is the M508, because Kylie doesn't have like a really small precise brush like this in her kit. And I'm just going to press this right here on my lower lash line and just drag it all the way from the outer corner, the inner corner of my eye. Right next to Enchanted, I'm gonna grab the shade Diva right here, which is one of my favorite colors in the palette. I mean, I say that pretty much about every single color, and I'm just gonna basically go right over what we just applied and just blend that out. So I want my lower lash line to be definitely green. I'm gonna pick the first shade up in my palette, which is called Enlight. I'm gonna use that to highlight the inner corner of my eyes. It really is a Makeup Geek day for me, you guys, because I wanna put a little bit of the Makeup Geek Voodoo foil pigment on my lower lash line really quickly, because it is so green. Like, nothing trumps this green. I just want to put a little pop of this. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. My inner waterline really quickly with some black liner. This is by Ardency Inn. It is my favorite Kohl pencil ever. Okay, let me just pop on some lashes and I will be right back. What a difference lashes make, right? Like, transformed. Okay, so now for bronzer, I'm gonna be using the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit, which is like the perfect shade of bronzer when you are really, really fair, like I am right now. I'm going to go in with the Kylie Jenner brush in number one right here. I'm still trying to figure out why these brushes cost so much, you guys. I'm just gonna be real. And I'm not a shady person. I'm really, really not. And I do know that natural hair is more to manufacture. I get it. I do not understand with this packaging, this hollow packaging on the inside. Like, it is literally the same packaging as the Morphe Gold Collection right here, if you can tell. Like, they feel the exact same. They both have the same rim. Like, they are the exact same thing. It's not a complete kit, if you ask me. Like, there's been several times in this video where I have had to grab other brushes from other brands because this kit does not have everything I need to complete a look. And for $360, I want to have every single brush that I need to complete my look. Let's go ahead and grab this brush and just bronze the face. I don't know. I definitely would like them to be like a little bit heavier and have a better range of brushes in this kit for that price. I'm gonna carve that out a little bit really quick just because I don't want it to look sloppy. I don't want like a harsh contour, but I don't need any sloppiness today. Mm-mm. Not today, Satan. Okay, I'm gonna contour my nose now and I'm going to use the exact same Hoola bronzer and I'm going to go in with the Kylie brush in number 11. It's actually a really nice brush for nose contour. I will say when I first saw the kit, I was like, what am I gonna use this brush for? Because it's like a harsh line, so I don't really want to blend with it, but this is actually kind of nice for this. For me, when it comes to getting the best nose contour, the actual contour powder is only the first step. Translucent powder is what really transforms my actual nose shape and gives me the best results. So I do the contour powder and then I sculpt out the side of my nose with the harsh side of this beauty sponge. Because if this is dark, then it kind of defeats the purpose of a nose contour. And then I put a line right down the center of my nose as well. So I'm trying to like talk and do it at the same time. For my cheeks, I'm going to use MAC Melba blush. I'm going to use the Kylie brush in number 3. Okay, this is actually a really, really beautiful blush brush. Like, I only had to touch my cheek for a half a second. And I actually really, I do like this blush brush a lot. Brush that off the side of my nose. Okay, for highlight, I'm gonna be going in with the Makeup Forever Starlit Powder in number 13. This is one of my favorite highlights ever. It's so beautiful, especially when I'm really fair. Like, I love this. And I'm gonna be using the Kylie brush in number 15. I typically like my highlighting brushes to be a little bit bigger than this, but I'm gonna use it for this anyways. I think she meant this to be a eyeshadow brush, but it's like too big for my eyes and a little bit smaller than what I prefer for my cheeks. But you know what? We're gonna make it work because when a highlight is this good, you really can't mess up no matter what brush you use. Yes, yes, yes. I don't understand why I always have texture on the right side of my cheeks. And you know what's weird is that it only pops up when I'm here in Florida, but as soon as I travel, it only takes 24 hours and it goes away. It's so weird. I've tried, woo, bitch. Okay, so now for the lips, I'm gonna be using a lip product that I have not yet tried, and this is the YSL Liquid Lipstick, and it is a bright red, because I just thought, why not make this extra Christmassy? I typically don't do a bold eye look like this with a bold lip. I would typically just do a nude, but I'm like, why not? Oh, this little brush is very interesting. Okay. This is kind of cool, because it's like a liner and a liquid lip all in one, because it's got this little precise brush. I haven't seen this wand before. That's so innovative. Okay, that applied like a wet dream. I did not overline my lips today for the first time, honestly, in like 2 years. I just thought like, let's tone it down a little bit and just do a natural lip line since the eyes are so crazy. And it feels weird for me actually a little bit because I'm always so used to doing just a little bit of an overline on the Cupid's bow, but we're rolling with it. So last but not least, I'm just gonna set my face. I'm using the Morphe Prep and Set Makeup Setting Spray. Oh, oh, oh.
Alright you guys, so this is the finished look right here as you saw in the beginning of the video. I hope that you enjoy this holiday kind of get ready with me makeup tutorial. Very Christmas classic. Oh wow. Mom is tired. Keep in mind that to recreate this look, you do not need the exact products that I used in today's video. You can recreate this look with any glitters, any shadows, any pigments that you have at home. I will say though that this liquid lipstick formula is absolutely beautiful. Now, I have not worn it all day or for several hours. I have not been eating or drinking anything. I've only had it on for about 30 minutes at this point. So I can't really like give you like a true like wear test. Yeah, wear test. But just my first initial impression is this is probably one of the best formulas I've ever used. Oh yeah, see, that's good to know. Like it's not 100% like liquid lip, like not going anywhere, but it is like so moisturizing. It just feels like my natural lip. It doesn't feel like I have anything on at all. It's so lightweight. Thumbs up to YSL for creating something so beautiful and luxurious and unique. Like this is awesome. That is it, you guys. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas. If you recreate this look in any way, shape, or form, make sure to tag me on Instagram, Twitter, snap me, do whatever you do, okay? I'll be there waiting. I love you guys and I'll see you in my next one. Mwah! Bye.